Hello, natural beauties. Welcome to my channel. My name is Nat, and today is going to be the third installation in my Freaky Friday series for the month of October. So what we are doing is we are not focusing on any makeup while we are talking during this video. We are mostly talking about urban legends. So if you are sensitive to supernatural stuff, creepy stuff, scary stuff, then you might want to click out of this video. I just want to give you a heads up. I'm not going to be like graphic or anything, but we are going to go ahead and get started. And the legend that we're going to be talking about is going to be from Chihuahua, Mexico. And we are talking about what is called La Pascualita. And that, it is actually a really old legend, and it's a local legend in the city of Chihuahua. And about 1930, they got this mannequin that appeared in a window of a shop. And right around the time the mannequin appeared, the shop owner, her daughter, died. And she died on the day of her wedding. And the legend goes that she was bitten by a black widow. And she was already in her wedding dress and everything. And she ended up succumbing to the venom, you know, from the spider. And so she ended up dying. And then, like I said, this mannequin appeared in that shop window. And it had an uncanny resemblance to the daughter of the shop owner who had recently died. And so the legend became that the shop owner, the mother, had preserved her daughter and had her in the window of the shop as a mannequin. And this mannequin is still there, y'all. I mean, like, and it seems like the city likes to keep the legend going, of course, because it brings, you know, it attracts visitors. And the shop is a wedding dress shop, and they see customers, and they dress the mannequin. And they have interviewed, like, employees, and some people have said that they believe the mannequin is a real person. And some of the things that are creepy, other than the uncanny resemblance of the mannequin to the shop owner's daughter who died, they also say that the mannequin, it's complete. It is complete. It doesn't have like arms that you can remove. It does not have legs that come off. The head doesn't come off. It is complete and it is anatomically correct. Okay, you know what I mean? Do you know what I'm saying when I say that? It's complete. Complete. It is a complete human figure. And only certain employees are allowed to undress it. Because, like I said, she sits in their window. And a lot of people will actually schedule a dress fitting, you know, like your wedding dresses. And this shop has like dresses made in Mexico. They can make their own custom dresses from whatever you want. They can get international dresses. So people will make appointments to try on the actual dress that the Pascualita is wearing. And another urban legend is that when you try on the dress that she's wearing, it brings you good luck. And so people will go and they'll wear it. And, you know, they hope for good luck with it. Now, the creepiest thing, and I looked at a lot of like videos and pictures, the reason why people believe that it's the shop owner's daughter who has been preserved is because it looks so much like her. It is a complete mannequin, And it's so realistic. Like, the eyes look incredibly realistic. They say that she has varicose veins on her legs, and her hands are so realistic, y'all. Like, the way they are shaped, I mean, it looks like a real person's hand. And so a lot of people say that she was once a woman and that she was preserved by her mother when she ended up dying prematurely on her wedding day. And people say that they have seen her eyes move while they're in the shop, and that they also can get like a sense of, they'll pass by people on the outside of the window, on the outside of the shop, they'll pass by, and when they turn around to look at her again, she's repositioned in a different position. And so she really does draw a lot of visitors, and they go, and I mean, it's got to bring so much revenue to that town. But they also say that she was taken to like an expose, you know, like an exhibit for mannequins. And the people, some of them think that she had something done to her while she was in Mexico City. And they're saying that it's not the same Pascualita. But, you know, the staff has said that, you know, she is a mannequin and she requires upkeep. And so sometimes they do have to, you know, do a little work on her. But the people were not happy about it. And some of them say that, you know, it's just not the same Pascualita anymore. But as far as the shop, it is still open today. And like I said, you can go in, you can actually buy your dress there. You can, you know, shop and try on her dress if that is your thing. But I think that it's so interesting, because why on earth would a mannequin have varicose veins? I mean, I don't understand it. I really, really don't. And on top of that, who makes a mannequin in one solitary total piece? That's just suspect, right, guys? I mean, like, that's not normal. And the staff is incredibly protective and secretive with her. So, like, when they do change her wedding dress, they do it, like, you know, away from others. It's done, like, in when the shop's closed and no one's around. And, I mean, I don't know how much of that is for, you know, keeping the folklore up, and how much of it is, I mean, why would you be that private with a mannequin? Well, I mean, I guess it makes sense if it brings that much revenue to your town, right? I mean, you would want to kind of play into it. But if you go online and you look at the actual pictures of the Pascualita and the mannequin, they do really look alike. And her eyes, her hands, and oh my gosh, I mean, I can't imagine how her legs look. But dude, those hands are so incredibly realistic and lifelike. And, you know, that's kind of been her home. And the town is known for it. And people flock there to go visit her and to try on dresses there. So I had never heard of this one before. And I do really like, you know, obviously these kinds of scary, superstitious, is it real, is it not? You know, I love these kind of stories, and I'd never heard of this one, but it is incredibly famous. And they have asked and had her, like, evaluated by, like, professional, I don't know, what are they called, like, not undertakers, but the people who do like the embalming and stuff. And they say that if you protect and if you embalm her and you keep her in a controlled environment, then you can have that embalmed body, I guess. You can keep it for like 7 to 10 years. But the thing is, the dress shop is not a controlled environment. You know, it's just like when they're there. And even then, I mean, even if it was like, you know, controlled when they weren't there as far as the environment, she has been in Chihuahua, Mexico, in that shop since 1930s. Well, since 1930, you know? So, I mean, if she were embalmed, she would probably have started decaying already. I don't know how that stuff works. I do think that's incredibly interesting, like, to be, like, a coroner. And, you know, they would know that kind of stuff. I think it's interesting. I think a coroner would know that. But, I don't know. Let me know. Do you know this story? Have you heard of it? Have you ever visited La Pascualita? I've never been to that part of Mexico, but it's definitely intriguing to me now. I don't think that I would ever go see it, but like if I were in the area, I'd be like, I wonder if I could, you know, go check that out. And I definitely would. But yeah, so I was really excited to have found something new that I hadn't heard of before, because the Freaky Fridays that we've done prior to this one, they were on La Lechuza and La Llorona. And those are really, really famous. But I had never really heard of La Pascualita. And y'all, I just, please look up her hands. Just go and look and Google La Pascualita and then see how you feel. Look at those hands, y'all. It's so weird. Here is our final look. And I'm so curious, y'all. Well, let me give you a good look at it so you can see what I did while I was off camera. A little bit of red match in here. But yeah, so that is my look. I am curious to know, were you aware of La Pascualita? Do you think that you're gonna go check out her hands because they're so creepy, y'all? But just the thought of a cadaver being in somewhere I am looking to find a beautiful dress just kind of creeps me out a little bit. And I'm dying to know your thoughts on this particular story. So thank you all so much for joining me. If you are interested in what I used on my face, go ahead and check the drop down below. If you're new here, I want to continue. I want to encourage you to consider subscribing and ringing that bell. Even if you don't, if you'd give me a like, I would appreciate that. And just know that I am sending you positivity, and I hope that you are doing what you love, and I will talk to you later. Bye, guys.